ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। हरि ओम। वी आर स्टडीइंग द कमेंट्री ऑफ भगवत्पाद शंकराचार्य ऑन द फोर्थ सूत्र ऑफ द ब्रह्म सूत्रास। हियर इन दिस सेक्शन शंकराचार्य इज एस्टैब्लिशिंग द डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन नॉलेज एंड एक्शन। When we say action, here of course, action propelled by desire or kamya karma is meant. So Shankaracharya says, jnanam tu pramana janyam. Knowledge tu indeed or but knowledge is born out of means of knowledge, pramana. Jnanam tu pramana janyam. Pramanam cha yatha bhuta vastu vishayam. And the means of knowledge, it is the object of, or means of knowledge has the object of yathabhuta vastu, an entity or a thing which is already existing. So the means of knowledge has for its object. That means using the means of knowledge, we know an object or entity that is already existing. Yathabhuta. And so because a particular entity or object is existing already, the knowledge of that particular object depends on the object itself. There is nothing to be changed in the object. The object has not to be produced because it's already in existence. There is no modification to be done in that object because the object as such is known. That is the idea here. The object is known as it is. Yatha bhuta vastu. So as it already exists, that object is known. Yatha bhuta vastu. And so, ataha, therefore, ज्ञानं कर्तुम अकर्तुम अन्यथा वा कर्तुम न शक्यम। न शक्यम, इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल। व्हाट इज इट नॉट पॉसिबल? ज्ञानं कर्तुम, टू डू नॉलेज। सो इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल टू प्रोड्यूस नॉलेज इन दैट सेंस, डू नॉलेज। अकर्तुम और टू डू इट इन अ डिफरेंट मैनर। अन्यथा वा कर्तु, अकर्तुम टू नॉट डू। सो इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल टू डू नॉलेज और नॉट डू नॉलेज और अन्यथा वा कर्तुम, टू डू इट इन अ डिफरेंट मैनर। व्हाई? बिकॉज़ नॉलेज इज नॉलेज, यू कैन नॉट चेंज इट। यथाभूत वस्तु विषय, नॉलेज इज ऑफ ए प्रेजेंट एंटिटी विच इज ऑलरेडी प्रेजेंट। You cannot change that knowledge. You cannot bring about that knowledge. You cannot alter the nature of the knowledge. Kevalam vastu tantram eva tad. Why? Because tad, that knowledge, is kevalam. Just vastu tantram eva. Indeed, it is dependent on the object of which it is the knowledge. So if you know that something is in front of you, say for instance, a book is in front of you, that knowledge depends on the existence of the book. And so that knowledge cannot be produced because the book was already there. It cannot be undone because the book is there and you see it and so you get the knowledge. So you cannot change the fact that the book is there. And it cannot be altered. There is only book. It is already there. You cannot change the fact that the book is there into something else is there. A cap is there or a coat is there. It cannot be changed because the knowledge is dependent on the object. In this example, it is the book. And na chodana tantram, it is also not dependent on chodana. That is the Vedic injunction, Vedic instruction. It is not dependent on Vedic instruction. So Vedic instruction, whatever is told in the Vedas, either as an injunction, as something that has to be done, or as a prohibition, that something that has to be not done or that should not be done. So here, na api purusha tantram, it is also not dependent on the activity of a person. On the action of a person. Because the object or the entity is present before even the process of knowledge takes place. So there's no need to act upon anything there. There's no need of any activity there. And so, na api purusha tantram, it is not dependent on the action of any person. Tasmat, therefore, manasatve api jnanasya mahat vailakshanyam. There is a great difference between knowledge and action, even though knowledge takes place at the mental level. So there is another, the Chandogya Upanishad is quoted. Yatha cha purusho vava gautama agnihi. So here what is said, yatha cha, just like purusho vava gautama agnihi. So a person, O Gautama, this man is indeed Agni. Man is indeed Agni. Purusho Vava Gautama Agnihi. O Gautama, this man is indeed Agni. When you say like that, then what does it mean? That this Agni has been given the concept of a man, or one contemplates the Agni or fire to be man. Purusho Vava Gautama Agni. So, O Gautama, this man is indeed fire. Or again from the Chandogya Upanishad, Yosha Vava Gautama Agni. Yosha, woman. So this woman is indeed fire. Ityatra, in this case, Yoshit Purushayoho Agni Buddhi Manasi Bhavati. The cognition or the knowledge, buddhi, of Agni, fire, in both Yoshit Purushayoho, in man and woman, it is Manasi Bhavati, it is mental. At the mental plane. But the problem is here, man is contemplated as fire, or fire is seen as man, or fire is seen as woman. So there is a contemplation on fire, leading to the results of fire being seen as man or woman. And so this happens at the mental level. But this is Purusha Tantra. Because what you see actually is fire. You don't see a man or a woman there. So it depends on the person's action of contemplation to see man or woman in the fire. So it's Purusha Tantra. Not only that, Kevala Chodana Janyatvat Tu Kriyaiva Sa. Kevala, just Chodana Janyatvat. Janyatvat, because it is born out of Kevala Chodana. Means mere Vedic injunction. Mere means just by Vedic injunction, instruction. Because it is born out of Vedic instruction, Sa, Kriyaiva Sa, that is Kriya Eva, that is indeed action. That is indeed action. Also, Purusha Tantra Cha, it is also dependent on the activity of a person. Yatu Prasiddhe Agna Agni Buddhihi. Whereas, Prasiddhe Agna Agni Buddhihi. To cognize or to have the cognition of fire in that which is popularly known as fire. Nasa Chodana Tantra. That cognition is not Chodana Tantra. It is not dependent on Vedic instruction. Na api Purusha Tantra. Also, it is not dependent on the activity of a person because what you see is quite self-evident as fire. Nobody is telling you to see, look upon the fire as a man or a woman. And because you see fire and know it to be fire, it is not dependent on any Vedic instruction or any activity to be done by you. It is dependent on the vastu, the object. Here, the object being fire. Kim tarhi, what then? If it does not depend on Vedic injunction or it does not depend on the activity of a person, what does it depend on then? Pratyaksha Vishaya Vastu Tantraiva Iti. So it is indeed Vastu Tantraiva. It is dependent only on the object, which is Pratyaksha Vishaya, which is the object also of direct perception. There are six means of knowledge: Pratyaksha, Anumana, Upamana, Anupalabdhi, Arthapatti, Shabda. So of that, the first Anumana, first Pramana, first means of knowledge, which is Pratyaksha Pramana, direct perception. So Pratyaksha Vishayavastu Tantraiva, it is indeed dependent on direct perception alone. Iti Jnanameva Etat. And so it is indeed knowledge, na kriya, it is not action. Evam sarva pramana vishaya vastushu veditavyam. In this manner, one should know about all the pramana vishaya vastushu, all the objects which are, or all entities which are the objects of means of knowledge. So, means of knowledge used to know whatever you know, all of them have to be understood to be knowledge. Because pramana means of knowledge, as it has been told, yatha bhuta vastu vishayam pramana. Pramana or means of knowledge, valid means of knowledge, has for its object yatha bhuta vastu vishayam. Yatha bhuta vastu, something which is already existing. Tatra evam sati. That being so, or means of knowledge being only knowledge and also means of knowledge being connected with objects of knowledge which are vastu tantra, which are dependent on the object and not on the activity of a person. Yatha, this being so, yatha bhuta brahma atma vishayam api jnanam na chodana tantra. So then if that is the case, then yatha bhuta brahma atma vishayam api, what is already existing, that brahman or atman, that also vishayam api, as far as that is concerned, also that also jnanam, that is knowledge, na chodana tantram, and it is not dependent on tantram, dependent on chodana, spiritual, scriptural, Vedic instruction. Tad vishaye lingadi linadayah linadayah shruyamana api aniyojya vishayatvat kunti bhavati. Tad vishaye linadayah linadayah shruyamana api. So though it is found, shruyamana, it is found in the scriptures, tadvishaya. Tadvishaya means regarding the subject, this subject. What is the subject? Brahma, the subject. Though it is understood in through the scriptures, aniyojya vishayatvat kunti bhavati, because they have for their object something which cannot be called a Vedic instruction or Vedic injunction, kunti bhavanti, it becomes kunti bhavanti, it becomes ineffective, irrelevant. Upaladishu prayukta kshura taishnyadivat, just like shura, knife, that is used on upaladishu. Upaladishu means stone. Upaladishu, stone. So when you adishu to stone and so on, that means things like a stone. When somebody is applying kshura, knife to that, prayukta, applying stone, then the taikshnyadivat, the sharpness, etc., of the knife, it goes down. Similarly, even though it has been told in the, it has been told in the Vedas, it has been spoken of in the Vedas, Brahman cannot be the object of Vedic instruction, or Brahman cannot be instructed through the Vedas. And that is why all the statements which supposedly talk about, instruct about Brahman, they are like kunti bhavanti. They are like they have lost their sharpness. Just like when you use a particular knife or something such, some such blade, against stone, etc., hard surface, then that sharpness is lost. Here again in the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, it is quoted here. The question asks is, Kimarthani tarhi atmava re drashtavyah shrotavyah. The very famous passage from the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. That is questioned, Kimarthani tarhi. If that is the case, then Kimarthani, what is the use or relevance or purpose of this mantra? What is the mantra? Atma va are drashtavyah shrotavyah. Oh, the Atman has to be seen, drashtavyah has to be seen, shrotavyah has to be heard. What is the purpose of such statements? What kind of statements are they? Ityadini vidichayani vakyani. Statements which are resembling vidhi, scriptural injunction. What is the point? What is the relevance of such sentences? स्वाभाविक प्रवृत्ति विषय विमुखीकरणार्थानि इति ब्रूमः. वी आर गोइंग थ्रू, इफ यू हैव ऑलरेडी नॉट रियलाइज्ड, वी आर गोइंग थ्रू अ पार्ट ऑफ व्हाट वी वेंट थ्रू लास्ट क्लास, सो दैट दिस आइडिया इज प्रॉपरली अंडरस्टूड. स्वाभाविक प्रवृत्ति विषय विमुखीकरणार्थानि इति ब्रूमः. The question asks is, kim arthani? Okay, if the knowledge of an already existing entity depends on the entity itself and not on the person obtaining the knowledge, that we understand. If that is the case, what is the purpose of this mantra, where it says that Atman has to be seen, it has to be heard, etc., which is chayani, means it resembles, it is as though it is a Vedic injunction, vidhi, Vedic instruction or injunction. It's as though it's a Vedic command. What is the purpose of such a statement? Swabhavika pravritti vishaya vimukhi karanarthani iti brumaha. So we say, brumaha, we say, the purpose of this mantra is to vimukhi karana, is to distract us, divert us from swabhavika pravritti vishaya, from our natural tendency of natural attraction, of going towards the sense objects. In the previous passage, there was one phrase, aheya anupadeya vastu vishayatvat. The Brahman, it loses its sharpness. Why? Because it is not something which is heya, it is aheya, it cannot be rejected. It is not something which is upadeya, that means it cannot be accepted also. And so that is the object which can neither be accepted nor rejected. And so it loses its sharpness, that is the idea. So any Vedic injunction has to be regarding something which is accepted, that is, which is done, injunction, or regarding something which has to be denied, which is not accepted, which is prohibition. Now, here, swabhavika pravritti vishaya vimukhi karanarthani ki brumaha. The idea of the mantra, which resembles an instruction, which resembles a command of the Vedas, is to divert oneself from one's natural tendencies, one's natural inclination of getting attracted to the objects, that is, sense objects. Yohi bhair mukha pravartate purushaha. So the person who pravartate purushaha bhair mukha, whoever acts or goes after bahir mukhah. So a person who acts externally, that person thinks ishtam me bhuyat. That person prays or thinks or desires the desired thing, ishtam, to happen. So a person who is concentrated on the bahirmukha pravartana, external transactions or external activities, believes or prays or wants to believe that purushaha ishtam me bhuyat, whatever is good for me, whatever is liked by me, that should happen. Anishtam ma bhut. And whatever is not liked by me, that should not happen. Like this, a person who is externally focused, most people, that person thinks like that. And so, na cha tatra atyantikam purushartham labhate. So there the final purushartha, goal of human life, is not got. That is, moksha is not got. Tam atyantika purushartha vanchinam. Those who are desirous of attaining that final, terminal goal of human life, that is moksha. Swabhavika karya karana sanghata. That person, swabhavika karya karana sanghata. That person, pravritti gochara, because of the natural inclination of swabhavika karya karana sanghata, of the complex or the coming together of karya means body, karana means mind. So the coming together of karya and karana, body and mind, and the object of the natural inclination of that, swabhavika karya karana sanghata pravritti gochara, because of it being the object. Vimukhi kritya, giving up or diverting. Pratyagatma srotastaya pravartayanti. What happens? Pratyagatma srotaha taya pravartayanti. That particular knowledge here, that pratyagatma srotaha taya pravartayanti makes one go towards the inner self. Pratyak means it is inner self of all beings. Atma srotaha taya. So this particular srotaha, this particular flow, it is going towards pratyagatma, going towards the self. And so, atma va are drashtavyah ityadini. How does that pratyagatma srotah flow? How does that flow of continuous meditations or flow of continuous, this incessant flow of the presence of atma, which is indwelling self? So what does it do? The statement atma va are drashtavyah shrotavyah, it turns us inwards towards our true nature by emphasizing that atma va are drashtavyah, atma va are drashtavyah ityadini, with statements like that. Tasya atma anveshanaya pravrittasya. There a person who has started putting efforts, or one who is putting efforts for atma anveshana, to understand one's true nature, to understand who one is, self-inquiry. Aheyam anupadeyam cha atma tattvam upadishyate. There, it is being instructed, aheyam anupadeyam cha. Aheyam, it cannot be rejected. Anupadeyam, it cannot be accepted, because it is a pre-existing entity. It cannot be rejected, it cannot be accepted. Cha atma tattvam upadishyate. But though it cannot be rejected, it cannot be accepted, that particular kind of atma tattvam, principle of atman, concept of atman, upadishyate, is being taught. What is it being taught? By the Upanishads. Idam sarvam yad ayam atma. Whatever you see here, everything is ayam atma, my atma. Whatever you see here is idam ayam atma, this atma. So ayam atma brahma, ayam atma brahma, prajnanam brahma. All these Mahavakyas are there. So this Atma is Brahman. Idam sarvam yat ayam Atma. All that you see here in front of you in this universe, that is Atma. So that kind of statement is done by the Shruti for a person who has set out on the journey to know Atma. Know Atma. Also, yatra tu asya sarvam atma eva abhut. For that person, yatra tu. For that person for whom all this jagat or all this universe, atma eva abhut, has become atma alone. That means one who has understood, one who has realized that this whole universe is nothing but Atman. For that person, tat kena kam pashyat, kena kam vijaniyat, vijyataramare kena vijaniyat. So for that person, kena kam pashyat, through what, who is known, kena kam vijaniyat, through what, who is known, kena kam pashyat, through what, who is seen. Vijnataramare kena vijaniyat. Who knows the knower? And then also from the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, I am Atma Brahman. Ityadilihi. This Atma itself is Brahman. Like this, all these Upanishad passages, they talk about Atma Tattvam, the principle of Atman, which cannot be accepted, which cannot be rejected. Means it is something which is existing. So it's not something which you can debate. It's not a debatable thing because it is in front of you. It's not debatable. So, Atyantika Purushartham Moksha. Moksha. Why Atyantika? Because all the sufferings at the three levels, mind, body, one level. Then other living beings, second level. Third level, other celestial or divine elements. Like flood, thunderstorm, etc. All these are three reasons for suffering. And Atyantika Purushartham means Atyantika Dukkha Nivritti also. So Purushartha, the goal of human life. Atyantika Purushartha, which is the ultimate goal of human life, which is moksha. So that moksha is happening only when one understands that this Brahman is yatra tu asya sarvam atma eva bhut. All this is nothing but Brahman. All this. And then one will ask the question, then how can I know that, or what are the means with which I can know that, or see that, or know that? And how can somebody know the knower? etc. This is the idea here. So here, the whole point of having instructions or instruction-like passages for the sake of, like in the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, instruction-like passages where you talk about Atma va are drashtavyaha. Atma va are drashtavyaha. And shrotavyaha. Atma va are. Atma has to be seen. Atma has to be heard. So that one has to realize. One has to realize that. Atma has to be heard. Atma has to be seen. Atma has to be seen, Atma has to be heard. And that Atman is I am Atma Brahma. So further, Shankaracharya says that Brahman can never become the object of a Vedic injunction. Brahman can never become the object of a Vedic injunction. It can never become. What is the logical drawback here? If Brahman becomes the object of a Vedic injunction, then Brahman is something which is born. And we know logically also by the Bhagavad Gita that whatever is born is bound to die. Jatasya hi dhruvam vrityuhu. So Brahman is not the object of any Vedic instruction or injunction. So that is what is being now told. Yadapi akartavya pradhanam atma jnanam hanaya upadanaya vana bhavati iti tat tathaiva iti abhyupagamyate. So, yadapi, also yat api, also this statement. Akartavya pradhanam, that which cannot be done. Akartavya pradhanam, that means that which is not dependent on an action. It cannot be, akartavya means that which cannot be done. That means it cannot be produced by action. Atma jnanam, knowledge of self or Brahman. Knowledge of self or Brahman which cannot be produced by action. Hanaya upadhanaya vana bhavati. It is also not something which can be hanaya, which can be rejected, or upadanaya, which can be accepted. It does not, this is also not that. It cannot be accepted, it cannot be rejected. Hanaya upadanaya vana bhavati iti tat tathayeva iti abhyupagamyate. So tathayeva abhyupagamyate. So it is accepted by us as it is. Iti tat tatha eva. It is like that. It is indeed like that. Iti abhyupagamyate. It is accepted. So some people would be there. They will never change. So no matter whatever you say, they will not change. Some people have this. There are many people like that. I'm just giving this example. This is no exhaustive example because that will be too much of a digression. So these people will be there. There are some people who, while you're talking to them open, they'll be suddenly like that, they'll spit. I really don't understand where that comes from. It comes from the bolt, like a bolt from the blue. Indra's Vajra thunderbolt, it comes like that. And suddenly they make this sound also quite, it is very cacophonic. It's like the tool they will spit. Then you are left wondering whether it is symbolic spitting or actually something is bothering that person's throat. Spitting in the middle of a conversation. Listen, whether they are spitting on your thoughts or symbolically on you, we don't know. It's really annoying. This is one instance. There are such so many annoying things. So you cannot do anything about it. You tell the person, see, this is not how it is done in civilized society. And probably it comes as a news that we are already civilized for that person. So then that person does not change. Then what you do? Then you have to do tat tathaiva. It is like that. Tat tathaiva. And I never tried to mention that we add one only to be safe. No. Tat tatha eva. He is like that only. He is like that only. So that's what is told here. Tat tathaiva. Iti abhyupagamyate. So Atman is like that. Indeed, it is like that. It is not dependent on any action. It is not something which can be accepted or rejected. And so, abhyupagamyate, we all accept that tat tathaiva, it is like that. Alankarohi ayam asmakam yad brahma atma avagatau satyam sarva kartavyata hanihi krita krityata chaiti. So here, the nature of Brahman is like that. Indeed like that. Alankarohi ayam. It is indeed an ornament. Ornament. That this indeed is an ornament. Asmakam yat Brahma Atma Avagato Satyam. So, Satyam, when that happens, what happens? Brahma Atma Avagato. When we know that we realize Brahman as Atman, or when we know that Atman and Brahman are identical, then what happens? Sarva Kartavyata Hanihi. Hanihi. Cessation or destruction, you can say, but here more appropriate is cessation of sarva, all kartavyata, all duties, all obligations. So all that has to be done by us come to an end. And it is only an ornament. That means it's superfluous. Alankara means ornament, means it's superfluous. Though we say, it doesn't really make any sense, and it is not necessary to say also. Because it is akartavya pradhanam. It is something which is brought about by not doing anything. Or to bring about this, you don't have to do anything because it's not brought about by any action. So it is akartavya pradhanam. And so it would be superfluous to say that when one realizes the self to be Brahman or Brahman to be self, either way. That means when one realizes that Aham Brahmasmi, I am Brahman, that means Atman and Brahman are identical. At that time, Sarva Kartavyata Hanihi, all obligations or all things which have to be done cease to exist. And Krita Krityata Cha Iti. Also, we accomplish all that has to be accomplished. Mean the same thing. There is nothing. All that has to be done is finished. And all that has to be accomplished is accomplished means actually it means the same thing. Why it means the same thing? Because this happens upon the realization of self as Brahman. Once that happens, no more kartavya or karma. No more duties to be done or no more actions remain. Tatha cha shrutihi. Also, it is said further in the Shruti or in the Upanishads, Vedas. Atmanam chet vijaniyat. I am asmi iti purushah. So, kimichan kasya kamaya shariram anusancharet. Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. So Atmanam Ched. Ched means if. If Atmanam Vijaniyat, I am Asmi Iti Purushah. If a person realizes that this Atma is this, I am Atma Asmi. That Atma is this. A person realizes that I am Atma. When a person realizes that, Kimichan, desiring what? Kasya Kamaya, and for whose purpose? Shariram Anusancharet. Would the person follow the body? That means, would the person continue in the body? If a person realizes that I am Atman, if a person realizes I am Brahman, then knowing that I am this or I am this Brahman, knowing this, what will the person desire or what will the person long for, want? And for whose purpose, kasya kamaya, will that person continue in the body? That's the question. There's no point in continuing the body. Also, Bhagavad Gita says, etad buddhva buddhiman syat kritakrityascha bharata. Oh, Bharata. Bharata means one who is a descendant of Bharata, King Bharata, coming in the lineage of King Bharata. Etad buddhva buddhiman syat kritakrityascha. Knowing this, you become wise. W-I-S-E, wise. You become wise and kritakritya hacha. And also you become one who has accomplished whatever is there to be accomplished. That means you become this. That means that person, after knowing Atman, there is nothing that person has to do. Iti cha smritihi. Mahabharata, written from memory, is smriti. Shruti is something which is eternal. So this smriti, part of Mahabharata, Bhagavad Gita is a part of Mahabharata. So in the smriti, in that it is said that etat buddhva, knowing this, buddhiman syat, be a wise person, krita krityascha, also you be a person who has accomplished whatever there is to be accomplished. Tasmat, therefore, na pratipatti vidhi vishayataya brahmanah samarpanam. So we cannot present, therefore, we cannot present Brahman, entity, Brahman, as pratipatti vidhi vishaya, as the object of pratipatti vidhi, as the object of an instruction, vidhi, instruction or injunction of pratipatti, contemplation. So there was another one objection or one suggestion by Mimamsaka philosophers, that yes, we accept that, okay, you are not doing any kind of action listening to this Shruti, Atma Vare Drashtavya, etc. Or Drashtavya, Shrotavya, Mantavya, Nididhyasitavya. You are not doing any action, but you are contemplating. And so this particular injunction might be considered an injunction for Pratipatti. That means contemplation. So that is also answered here. No, we cannot hold this mantra to be an injunction or instruction on contemplation of Brahman, because this kind of an injunction has not to be done by a person who has already understood one's nature. And so there is nothing remains to be done. And so it's not acceptable. That's what here it is said. So tasmat, therefore, we cannot present, or we cannot consider Brahman to be something which is an object of or the result of an instruction of injunction or instruction of contemplation. So here it has been proven that Brahman is not, or this particular statement is not, an injunction to do Vedic ritual or Vedic injunction. And it is also not some subsidiary or auxiliary to a Vedic instruction. It is also not an instruction to contemplate. Also, it is not just another action, because the Upanishads say, they are telling it as though it is an action. It is not an action. And it also depends on the vastu, the object of knowledge, which is yatha bhuta, which is already existing. It does not depend on purusha, the person. And also, it is something which does not have any beginning. It is something which is not based on karma. It is something which is different from a mental action. Like mental action, considering something to be something else, like considering seeing man in fire. So contemplating man in fire, that is an intellectual or mental action. But the knowledge of Brahman is not a mental action, and not a mental action. All these things we have covered. And further, we will see how what the Upanishads say are nothing but the knowledge of Brahman. That is Upanishad, Aupanishada, Aupanishada Vakyani. So Upanishadic sentences, they talk about only Brahman. And so that we will see. And so it is only true to the tenor, general tenor of Upanishads, or general nature of Upanishads, that they talk about Brahman alone. That we will see later. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu. Any questions? Okay, so I have a question for a change. I have a question. Smriti, shall I ask a question?
Yes, Swamiji.
So my question is, this Brahman, if we cannot say that it is based on an action, okay, action either done by us or action instructed by the Vedas, either action of doing some ritual or action of contemplating. So here it is clear that this is not based on any of the actions. Also, it is based on Brahman itself. So the question is, why then do we need to do anything at all about this? Why can't we just keep quiet? Suppose it is our true nature, okay. And it cannot be brought about by action or contemplation. Then what do we actually see, that all people are running after meditation, prayer, worship, etc.? Why is it necessary? Why can't we just keep quiet? If anyone can answer it now, very good. If one cannot, day after tomorrow, we can continue with this question. Smriti, can you answer that question?
Yes,
I'm not sure, Swamji. I think action can stop only if you reach that nirvikalpa samadhi state. Until then, nobody can not do anything. They have to do it.
My question, let me put it again. Though Brahman, knowledge of Brahman cannot be brought about by actions, why are we then doing all these exercises of contemplation, meditation, etc.? One clue. We have already seen that. Today also we saw that. Nobody?
Because the sense organs are going outside, we have to do the this activities.
You came close, but that today we saw the text where it is said, last class also we saw. Anybody?
Only in silence we could. That's the reason every action what we do has to go to silence, is what I think, Swamiji.
Now what Shankaracharya is saying, that's what I'm asking. Means he's giving a reason, and that anyway, so let us close for now. Day after tomorrow, please go through what we have already studied today, just what we studied today, and in that the answer for this question is there. It has been answered by Shankaracharya himself. Okay, Shubharatri. Shubharatri.
Shubharatri. Thank you so much.